everyone. I'm Broken Bones, and welcome back to another episode here on the Bonehead server. Today is episode 3, and as you can see, we're here at a fish farm. This is the fish farm that Doc Zer has so kindly built for us, which is really awesome, because as you can see, I've got tons of items, and we've got tons of levels, so we're doing pretty good on that. But I thought we'd start things out here today, so you could take a quick look at my entire area from up here, because as you can see, it's pretty nice. I mean, we got the villager breeder, we have our castle mountain that we're going to be building our castle on here shortly, and we're also going to be having our residential area in the front there, and pushed into the mountain in the front is going to be our shops, and then in the back here obviously is going to be our industrial district where everything is going to be built for function and redstones. This is going to be my forte back here. This is all my this is all the stuff that I like to do, all the redstone stuff. So but a lot has happened in the last week since the last episode. As you can see, I haven't cleaned up any of the mess from the previous episode. And the villager breeder actually got attacked by a zombie and died. Most of the villagers died. We had about 2 left. Doc Zer was able to go ahead and reproduce them. And now we have a way for them to go into the nether. So now we have an infinite villager breeder where they're constantly going to the nether and they're getting trapped in there. So we have probably close to 100 villagers on the server at the moment in the nether, so we're doing pretty good on that. But in today's episode, we're going to be building some farms, and we might get around to laying out our new castle. We'll see how far we get, because it is Saturday. I haven't done much this week as far as recording wise. I've done a whole bunch of resource gathering and mining and things like that, but nothing really intensive. I've had a super busy week, which is why Doc has built this for me, which is super helpful, so thank you, Doc. And so yeah, I was just thinking that we'd go ahead and get the episode started here, and I think we're gonna go ahead and start clearing up this mess right here. As you can see, there's no dirt there, it's just a bunch of stone, because in one of the previous episodes I had my team come over and they completely flattened out this entire area. I think that was on episode 1. If you haven't seen that, I recommend you go check that out, because it was a great time lapse. It was really fun and all the guys enjoyed it. So anyways, we're gonna go ahead and hop down there and we're gonna get started. Alrighty, so we've made our way down to the bottom and we're completely ready to be taking out all this material and replacing it with some dirt. As you can see, I've got a bunch of dirt in my inventory, so that'll flush up things a little bit. And so we're ready to go. We're gonna go ahead and take this out, and I think we're gonna be cleaning up this mess too, this drop chute from the villager breeder down to the iron golem farm. We're done using that, so we're gonna clean that up as well, and I think we're gonna do that in a split screen time lapse. Yeah, we're gonna go a little old school for you guys. I think that should be a lot of fun. I miss those.
I really want you to step
we're looking pretty good now. Hope you guys enjoyed that time lapse. I love doing those. So now we're going to go ahead and get laid out on our build site, and we're also going to grab some of the items that we're going to need for this build. Alrighty, we have got all the items that we need for this build, and we also have our infinite water source for filling up our water buckets, and we also have our area laid out. We have the torches in all of the corners, so I'm going to go ahead and get ready and start taking out some of this dirt. Let's see, we're going to be starting off right around here. Yep, that's going to be right there. This is where we're going to start. So we're going to go ahead and start clearing out some of this dirt right here, and I'll catch you when we're finished with that. Alrighty, we have cleared out all the dirt, and we've got a marked our area that we're going to be trenching out. This is where all the items are going to be flowing into, so we're going to be carving that out and placing in the ice. So we're going to go and get started on that. I'm going to go ahead and trench this out right here. There we go. Alright, and I'll catch you when I'm finished with this one. Okay, now we have everything trenched out. We have our storage area cleared out. We're going to go ahead and lay in the ice and get ready to put in the transportation system. So the ice is going to go ahead and lay in here just like so. We're going to go ahead and lay it like this. Then this side comes down one deep, and then we're going to go ahead and continue the ice over here. Just like that. All right. Then we're going to go ahead and come over here, continue that down. Just like so. This is going to continue all the way down to the end. Just like that. There we go. All right. Come over here. Clear that out. Okay, this comes down by one. And that continues up like that. Okay. Oop, looks like we're missing one ice. Okay, I've got the last piece of ice that we need. There we go. All right. Now we're going to go ahead and drop down here with our hoppers. We're going to come down here just like so. Okay, and we're going to go ahead and get it into the back of this guy right here, just like that. There we go. All right, now we can go ahead and come down here. We're going to remove all these cobblestone blocks. They should, all these hoppers should be facing into these cobblestone blocks. There we go. Then we're going to go ahead and add the chest onto the front of those. And before we do that, we're going to go ahead and add some stone brick in the back here just for aesthetics. Let's see, there we go. Okie doke. And then we're going to go ahead and take our chest just across, just like that. Oop, there we go. We got a crouch. There we go. All right, just like so. All right. Okay, now it's time to start placing in the floor and some of the decorative bits that are going to really start bringing this build together. So we're going to go ahead and place these stone slabs around outside the perimeter. We're going to go ahead and take our stone bricks, place these in the center, and then we're going to go ahead and take these stone bricks. We're going to place them around the outside just like so. There we go. Yep, and then coming around this way, same thing on this side. Oop. There we go. All right, now we're going to take our spruce plank, or our spruce wood, and we're actually going to come up like that. We're going to come straight down, oop, just like this. Nice, I like the way that looks. That looks clean. All right, so let's go ahead and get rid of this guy. Okie doke. So now we're going to go ahead and add another block right up here. Put in our spruce wood. Really looks good. I like how rich that looks. All right, now we're going to go ahead and add another one right here. Let's see. We need a block up there. There we go. All right, and same thing up here. Let's see if we can just add it on the bottom of this torch here. There we go. Okay, now this build's really starting to come together. So now we want to go ahead and take this guy out. There we are. All right, we're going to replace that with stone bricks as well. Okay, so now we have our storage system complete, and all we need is a couple ladders to get us up and out of here. There we go. All right, and then let's see, we need some more stone bricks to get us all the way out of here. There we go. Okay. Alright, so that's done. Now we're going to go ahead and fill this in with some more stone brick, and I'll catch you when we're finished with that one. Alrighty, we're just filling in the last couple blocks here. We're just going to be filling this up. There we go. Alright, then we're going to be adding dirt on top of this once we get all this blocked in. Let's see here. There we go. Okay. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and add our water sources here in the corners. There they go. All right. Okie doke. And now we're gonna be adding our half slab right here, so that way the water does not go back. And we're gonna be putting it on the top. You gotta make sure it goes on the top so the items can flow right underneath. And then we're gonna add our last bucket of water right there. That'll complete the transportation system for all the items. Now we're gonna go ahead and take all of our, let's see, all of our dirt. Let's go ahead and go like that. There we go. All right, so we're gonna take our dirt and we're gonna come right across here just like this. All right, now that we have all of our dirt in, we're going to go ahead and place a couple blocks around the front like so. We're going to go ahead and block this off right here and drag a big line down the middle just like this. There we go. Break this block out. We don't need that one. There we are. Bring that all the way down to the end. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to count 8 blocks to where we're going to place our water sources. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's where we're, our water source is going to be. And that should drain out just to the end there, like so, nice and perfect. Awesome. All right, now we're ready for the next step. Okay, next we're gonna go ahead and place some blocks here just like this. Bring these all the way down the line, just like so. Yeah. All right, then we're gonna go ahead and continue the same thing on the other side, just like this. Come across here, click that block. All right. Then we're going to go ahead and bring this line down just like so. Ooh, let's see here. There we are. All right, okay, so now we're going to go ahead and bring this all the way down. All right, so now we're going to go ahead and take our pistons. We're going to take our pistons and go ahead and come up just like this. Lay these all the way in here just like so. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and take our blocks like this. We're going to come up here like that and come up to the front here. And we're going to go ahead and make one more line that comes all the way up just like this. All right, so now that we're done with that, we're ready for the next step. Okay, so we're going to get ready to go ahead and put some of the redstone in, but first we're going to go ahead and lay our sugarcane down so that way these bud pistons don't actually go off and push us off the edge and make it inconvenient to do this, so better to do this first. So let's go ahead and complete this side as well. Let's go ahead and grab that one as well. There we go. All right, so now we're going to go up top here. Let's go ahead and grab our ladders, climb up top. There we go. Okie dokie. Now we're going to come around here, grab our redstone, bring that all the way down the line like this, like this. Okay, now that we have our redstone out of the end, we're going to go ahead and take a couple blocks like this. We're going to bring these out like that so we can place some pistons facing straight down like this. There we go. All right, then we're also going to come back up here. We're going to place 2 pistons facing straight up from there. There we go. All right, so now we're gonna go ahead and take our gravel. We're gonna place that right there and that right there. Now we're gonna go ahead and delete these blocks right here. And we're gonna go ahead and replace these guys right here. Oop. Take that guy out. All right. Okay, so now we're going to take our furnaces. We're going to place these down like this, inside-wise, that way you don't see that face. And then we're going to go ahead and take one item. We're going to go one item just like this. All we need is one. There we go. All right, then we're going to take one in here. There we are. Okay, so now we're going to come around the front. We're going to place some half slabs coming out in a U shape just like this. Just like that. There we go. There. All right. So now we're also going to bring some blocks in. We're going to bring block in coming in right here. And let's see, a half slab's coming in right here. Okay, so now we're also going to be bringing in these comparators. All right, these comparators are going to take a signal out of that furnace behind there. As you can see, it lit up. So we're going to come in there just like that. Do that. All right, and then that's going to come into a solid block like so. There we are. And then we're going to come out with one more half slab just like this. There we are. And then we're going to grab our redstone once again. Go like that. And then we're going to get our torches. Place these in just like so. There we go. All right, now we're going to grab our repeater. There we are. Okay. Then we're going to go ahead and put that going into a block. Just like that. Into a redstone torch. Then that's going to go ahead and carry redstone dust all the way down it just like that. And that should carry all the way down to the end, which it does. Perfect. Alright, so now that we have our bud update detection, all of our pistons are bud powered, so now anytime a item goes in front of it, it automatically powers all the pistons on that side. Both sides are currently working, so that's really awesome. This thing's coming together. So now you guys know how to make the first level. I'm gonna go ahead and make a second level, and I think I'm gonna do that in a split screen time lapse, and you guys should have a lot of fun watching that. Guys, I hope you guys enjoyed that time lapse. I enjoy doing those. And yeah, doesn't this thing look good? Especially at nighttime. I mean, it glows right in the dark, so it's Kind of nice looking at it right now. Sorry it's raining, but... Yep, so check this out. While we were building, and also it is the next day too. So we got a lot of sugarcane now, so we're doing pretty good. We'll be using some of this to trade with some villagers later. We'll turn it all into paper and get some emeralds. But first, me and Ragnarok were busy last night, and I was just kind of tired after work, and we were just kind of playing around. Because as you know, I have my castle that I want to build right behind me. And we kind of got started on it the other night and just had a few ideas. And this is kind of what we came up with. That's going to be part of my castle, I think. And I kind of like it, so let's go up there and take a better look. Alrighty, we're up on top of our mountain now. And this is what me and Ragnarok were working on last night. I really like the way it looks. I think it looks really, really cool. I'd like to know you guys' thoughts. Please let me know what you guys think down in the comment section. And yeah, so this is the top of my mountain. And as you know, this is my castle mountain. So we've kind of had this circle right here. I generated that using Voxel Generator from, it was a phone app. So yeah, I'll try to include the link on that in the video or in the description. So, and but yeah, this is just looking awesome. I'm totally stoked about this. I think we're gonna go ahead and go with it, but first I think we're gonna go ahead and grab some of our sugarcane, craft it up into some paper. And Doc has done a fabulous job at making a villager trading system, kind of. It's not really professional yet, but it's just it's a way to trade with villagers. But I think it'd be really cool to go get some emeralds, so we're gonna go do that really quick. Alrighty, so let's go ahead and go down in here. Let's pop in here, grab us some sugarcane. See, yep, just grab all this stuff. I'm gonna be turning it all into paper because librarians like to turn paper into emeralds. Alrighty, we're coming up here, and it looks like another player's up here, Be Free. He's one of the new members on the server, really good guy. Let's see here, we got our paper in hand. Let's go ahead and see who's offering 25 emerald or 25 paper for an emerald. Let's see, 24 paper for an emerald. 26, 28, 31, that's not a good deal. 34, that's even outrageous. 25, that's not too bad, but we have a 24 over there. So 27, 29, and 25. All right, so let's go ahead and start over here at the 24. Let's lock out his trade. We're going to go ahead and see what we can do here. There we go. Right on. Okay, so we got 8 emeralds out of that. That's awesome. Okay, 10 actually. Okay, now let's see. Where's the 25, dude? All right, so let's give you some paper, get some more emeralds. All right, let's go back over here to this guy because he's still got more. All right, and as you can see too, I don't know if you guys noticed, but I'm getting XP from trading with villagers, and also it also makes your villager score go up, which is also very good. But yeah, we're doing pretty good right now. This guy just keeps on replenishing his item right there. As long as you see those green stars right there, he's got paper again. That's awesome. That means he's got more emeralds to give. Come on, do it again, do it again. Yeah. Yeah, we're getting a lot of emeralds out of this guy. 47 we're up to. Man, come on, do it one more time. Do. Yeah! Dude, this guy is just going on forever. I'm amazed he's not locking out. Come on now. Do it again. Man, he's taking all of our paper. That's awesome. Dude, we got a stack of emeralds. We have a stack of emeralds. Do it again. Do it again. Oh, he did it! Oh, man, this guy's going on for days. Oh, we have a little bit left? Yeah, we have one more emerald to get. Come on. Come on now. Sweet. And he's locked out. Look at, no, I'm locked out because I don't have any more paper. Well, we can always get more. Okay, so we still have quite a bit left in our chest. Let's go ahead and take all of this. We're going to go ahead and bag all this up and then head right back to the villager trading center, or what we call a villager trading center right now. Okay, we're making our way up to the top. Let's go ahead and craft our sugarcane into some paper. right there. Nice. Alrighty, so we've got all of our paper now. Let's go ahead and head back to this guy, see how many more we can get out of him. Let's see here. Nice, alright. Do it again. Is he gonna do it again? Oh, yes, that's awesome. This is the cheapest guy for paper, and he keeps on unlocking his trade. Usually you have to do a couple of these for him to unlock. This is awesome. He's been doing it every time. There we go. Nice. There we go. Okay. Locked out a little bit sooner that time. Nice. This is awesome. Tons and tons of emeralds. Just off that little sugarcane farm we built. That's nice. Alright. You got paper again? No. You got no more paper. Because you're all locked out. That's right. Alright, so see, now we got to do something else, because now he doesn't want anything, so, let's see, he doesn't have a very good glass trade. There's other villagers that sell glass for 5 emeralds, but, let's see, what does he offer in a book? Looting 3? You know what, my sword doesn't have any enchantments. That sounds like a good one to add. Let's go ahead and buy ourselves a bookshelf. Let's try that. Let's see. I think we can break those by hand and they turn into books. Let's try that here real quick. Heck yeah, there we go, right on. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and go right over here and buy us a book. There we go. So hopefully he unlocks his trade again. Come on. Where's them green stars? Come on, I just bought a book off you. Oh, he did unlock his trade, right on. Okay, so I wonder why I didn't say so in there. Alright, so now we locked out again. Come on, buddy. Come on, keep on going. Do it again. Come on, you know you want to. Let's see here. What else can we get from him? We don't need a compass, really. I don't need a clock. Let's see. Lure 2. Smite 4. Name tag. Don't really need any of these things. Gosh darn it. Let's see here. He locked out too. He doesn't have his paper trade either, but he does have 5 glass. That's worth buying. Let's go ahead and lock that trade out. Let's see here. Mending 1. I get a lot of those in the fish farm. Let's see. Fire protection. Get a lot of those. Okay, so let's see what he does. You know, restart. Come on, buddy. Man, what a tough crowd today. Come on, all I want is some emeralds for some paper. I got a little bit of paper left. Alright, so let's see. This guy was 26. There was another 25 in here somewhere. Right here? This is guy's 25, yep. Let's see. Gotta be careful because we don't want to buy that book. Right there. Do not press X and buy the book because that book's no good. And we don't want it. But let's see. What else can we get? What is that? Fortune 1. Fire protection. Okay. So, not too bad. But let's see if he restarts his trade here. Come on, buddy. Alright, cool. So, we got that back. There we go. Okay, we're out of paper now. So, we've got ourselves... Let's see how much. A stack and 29. So, almost a stack and a half of emeralds just from that little sugarcane farm from running overnight. So, that's not too bad. Let's see. I'm going to go ahead and see if I can find a villager in here that... has a good trade for emeralds. Dude, right off the bat, first villager I choose, look at this, look at his trades. Okay, rotten flesh, not too good, but he trades 9 gold for an emerald. And then he also offers redstone, which is cool. Lapis lazuli, that's cool. Then an ender eye for 8 emeralds, that's not too bad. Glowstone for an emerald. And bottle of enchanting, that is awesome because that's a really easy way to get levels. So, but that's so awesome. Let's see. We might end up coming back to this guy and grabbing some glowstone. I'll have to remember he's here. But let's go ahead and check out a few others. Let's see. Diamonds. I don't need to give up 4 diamonds for an emerald, but let's see. Efficiency 2 and breaking 1 and fortune 2. Not too bad, but I'm going to go ahead and check out a few more and see what they have to offer. Right on. Check this guy out. So he sells full chainmail. That's awesome. I only thought you could get that off of zombies and skeletons that were wearing it. I didn't know you could buy it off of villagers. That's pretty cool. Because that's rare gear right there. That's pretty awesome. So I'm going to go ahead and keep on going around and see what they got. This librarian right here has respiration 3. But that's about the only one. But that's actually pretty good. That's not too bad. So let's see. What do these guys have? Fortune 3? That's pretty nice. Let's see. I think I'm going to go ahead and grab one of those books for sure. Let's see here. Glass. Looting 2. Alright, so let's go ahead and move on. This guy here sells an efficiency 5 book. Dude, that's awesome. We're definitely getting one of those. Let's see. What else do they have? Glass. What is that? Punch 1. Alright, okay. Moving on. Dude, this shepherd right here sells every color of the wool right here. Every color of the rainbow in the wool department right here. Dude, that is so awesome. I didn't know you could do that with villagers. I mean, I'm still going to create a really awesome sheep farm, but dude, how convenient. Alrighty, well, we're going to go ahead and head on back now. There's a bunch of cool villagers up here. We're going to definitely take a look at them again. And for now, we're going to go ahead and get ready to start building our pumpkin and melon farm. I can't wait to go back up there and do some more trading. So we're going to go ahead and get some more items and get ready to build this thing. Alrighty, I've been running around my base collecting a bunch of stuff, and we finally got most of the items here together. These are the items that we're going to be needing for the build at hand, and the only thing that we're missing right now is some spruce wood. As you guys know, I took a bunch of spruce wood out there, out back in the industrial district, and I've used it all up, and all I have left now is some oak wood. That's all I've got. So we're going to go out there and go ahead and get ourselves some spruce wood and see how much we can get. Alrighty, we have gone out and got ourselves some spruce wood now, so we have what we need for the build. And we're going to come on over here, where the corner of our build is. The redstone torch marks the corner. We're going to go ahead and start taking out some dirt here. We're going to make a 9x9 circle. Oop, took out one too many dirt. There we go. Go ahead and put that there. And we're going to go 9 blocks in this direction, and 9 blocks in the other direction, and 2 blocks down. So I'll catch you when I'm finished with that one. Alrighty, we have our area dug out here. We're going to go ahead and come down and start laying in some rails. But first I want to show you guys something funny about rails. I don't know if you guys knew this, but rails don't go in the direction you want them to go. As you can see, I'm laying them down this way, and they keep turning that way, no matter what I do, no matter what you do. And that's because rails do their own thing. No matter how you lay them, they just don't do anything. See, even if you go like this, right here, they still don't go the way you want them to. They still turn. So there's not much we can do except make sure that we can lay our farm out in this direction. So what we're going to do here is we're just going to go ahead and put some power railed in the center, and we're going to break all these out here. There we go. We're going to count 5 blocks into the center. There we are. Go ahead and break that block out. We're going to go 2 blocks down, and this is going to be a row of redstone torches, and that's what's going to be powering the powered rails above. So we're going to take all this out. There we go. Place in all of our torches just like so. Perfect. All right, now we're going to dig ourselves out. Nice. Okie doke. Then we're going to go ahead and take our stone and fill all this in right here. Just like that. Perfect. Oop. Alrighty, just a little quick mistake. There we go. Alrighty, now we're just going to make sure that we place in our powered rails on top of that. Now, over in this direction is going to be where the minecart's going to be dropping into this level. So we need to make sure that there's a power redstone torch beneath here too. So we're going to go ahead and dig these 2 blocks out, grab our... Well, actually, we don't have a redstone torch. We got to make one. So we're going to go ahead and take that guy and place her down in here. There we go. Alright, go ahead and take our stone, cover that up, and place our powered rail on top of that. Now we're going to go and take our regular rails and go all the way to the center, and then place a powered rail. We're going to do that all the way through the farm, and I'll catch you guys when I'm done with this. Alrighty, we have all the rails in place now, And the next step is we're going to be digging out some of this area down here to be placing in our unloading system. This is where the minecart's going to be dropping down and unloading all of its items into our storage system. And I've built a little model over here for you guys. As you can see, this is just a quick little miniature version of it. And basically what we have here is we have a detector rail throwing a pulse into this comparator, which will detect that and place power into that repeater, which is going to invert this redstone torch here. Now, that has a quick delay and has just enough delay for the minecart to come over here, start unloading items for this comparator to detect that out of the hopper and invert that torch as well, which also puts a signal into that repeater, which powers that rail, which sends the minecart back. So that's what we're going to be using. And so we're going to go ahead and get started on placing this guy in here, and I'll catch you guys when I'm finished with that. Alrighty, we have our area dug out for our unloading system. First things first, we're going to come over here where the minecart's going to drop down on this thing. We're going to take this block out right here. We're going to put in our regular rail, and we're going to lay some blocks in just like this. We're going to go ahead and skip the eighth one. We're going to put our ninth one in just like that. And this one here is going to be our hopper, which, let's see, which one do we want to take out? Any, mini, mini, mo. There we go. All right, we're going to go ahead and place this hopper down just like that with a powered rail. Oop, got to crouch. There we go, powered rail on top of that one. Now we're going to go and do the unloading system. We're going to take a comparator out of this hopper here. So when it's unloading, it'll throw a signal into this block. And this block will have a redstone torch on it, which will be inverted when there's items in there. And then a redstone torch is going to go into that block, which is going to power this repeater right here, which powers our rail. So that's the unloading system all done and dusted. Next thing is to get our detector rail in place. So we're going to come back 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks like that with a detector rail right there on that one. There we go. We're going to fill in the rest of the rails right here. There we go. Now we're going to go ahead and put a block right here. There we go. With a comparator, just like so, with another block like that, with some redstone dust underneath, which is going to go into a repeater, sorry, with some redstone dust going into that block, which will also invert that torch, which will turn off that rail as well. So that's the delay system, which keeps the minecart there. So that's all done and dusted. Alrighty, well, after an hour of research, I've really found no way to actually get the minecart to go up to the very top via redstone. The only way that I could figure out how to do it is just your regular old railway. We're going to have to make a staircase railway going up to the top. And to show it to you guys, I actually have a couple models back here. And as you can see, if you take your minecart here, like this, and you place it down, and you push that forward. Now that's in a translocation piston system, which is the one that's in the tutorial. But as you can see, on console, it just doesn't work. It doesn't work, so. And if you take it over here, if we make ourselves a minecart hopper, let's see right there. All right, so take this guy, break it in the cactus, and see, it just doesn't work. The hopper's in my hand. They break into two pieces, so that's just not going to work. So there's really no other way that I can think of to make the minecart go up via redstone. So I'm just going to have to make a regular railway all the way up to the top. And if you guys have any ideas of how I could do this, if you guys figure something out on console, please let me know, because I'd love to do something cool to bring this thing up to the top rather than just a railway system. So, but that's what I'm going to use for now, and we're going to go ahead and move on with the rest of the build.